second spirit speaker is on the waiting, right? I would like to, without wasting much of time, I would like to invite Mr. K. Sri Ramesh. He is the founder. He is the founder of MFD Universe. And after demonetization, अगर सबने एक शुर में इंडिया में अगर कोई एक ही वर्ड बोला है डे और नाइट, दिन और रात, तो वो एक ही टॉपिक है जीएसटी. इज इट सो और नो? तो द अवर दिस टॉपिक इज ऑन अबाउट जीएसटी. तो गिव हिम अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज एंड आई एम हैंडिंग ओवर द माइक टू रमेश सर.
थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स एंड माय टाइम स्टार्ट नाउ. एग्जैक्टली 30 मिनट्स. आई नो दैट half an hour, but I'm making it short and quick for you. Now, by 5:55, I'll finish it. See, let me start and go. For us, is GST required or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Anybody know here? Anybody says no? It is yes. So, that's because we are doing interstate. Tax liability comes for us. That's the reason why we need GST. We should register ourselves. See, what role? Because we are providing the AMC which is outside our state. We are not in Maharashtra. We are in Tamil Nadu, Kolkata, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal or wherever it is. So, and that is the one reason. And what is the threshold limit of 20 lakhs? Is the threshold limit of 20 lakhs is correct? Even within the state, let us suppose I am doing a business in Maharashtra. I buy from Pune. Pune is in which state?
Maharashtra.
I buy from Pune and sell it in Pune itself. Let us suppose I am buying a motor. It is a 20 lakhs is just an eyewash, my dear friends. Understand that. If I buy motor from your Pune and I sell it in Mumbai, and people say that up to 20 lakhs no GST is required. But as a registered member, I come and ask you, sir, I would like to buy a motor from you. What you will say? Yes, sir, we are ready. Motor will cost you 18,500, sir. And I will prepare a bill. Oh, you are not GST registered, huh? Sorry, I am not supposed to buy from you. As a registered dealer, please note, a registered dealer cannot deal with the unregistered dealer for more than 5,000 rupees a day across India. So, it means it is 20 lakhs is an eyewash. Every registered dealer is supposed to deal only with the registered dealer. Then, as a registered dealer, will I go and buy from him motor? No. So, automatically, he will also get himself registered. Please understand that 20 lakhs is an eyewash. And that will slowly, it will make people, all everybody, to get themselves registered. And location, commission based, if you are dealing on commission based, AMC's location is considered, not your location. And if you are dealing on fee based, there are RIA friends here, fee based means client location is considered. That means you have to do it in multiple location. You have client in Bangalore, Karnataka. You have client in Pune, do it in Maharashtra. You have client in Kolkata, do it in West Bengal. That's a problem for RIAs. Your problem? Be happy. Great. You heard the session? Happy. Great. That's it. So being a MFD, be happy. Now you are all MFDs. Be happy because you have to do it only with one state. You are happy. So next point. And one more, if you have multiple business, I see people doing only, not only this one, mutual fund alone. They do multiple business. Don't worry, if you want all the slides, I can pass on to the team, you will get it also. If you do it with multiple states, multiple business. I am having a Xerox shop also. I have a Panwala, this thing, Dukan also. Other things all I have to have different numbers. That is one PAN. And the last number will change. Last number will be, first two digit will be your state. Other numbers will be your PAN number. Then number one for your first business, 2, 3, 4, like that for your different businesses. IZ, next digit will be IZ. IZ is a number which they are going to decide it later. And finally, one more result or X or Y or some number will come. To get yourself registered, how many people not registered so far for GST? That's a majority here. See, do you know what is the last date for registration? It is 31st July. But need not worry, our Modi is helping us a lot. He is saying that till 30th of, it's always great, na? So till 30th of September, there will not be any penalty. But please, friends, do it before 30th of September. How to do it? Just go to the website gst.gov.in. This is the website you have to log in. Once you log in, you have to go to the new registration part. Once you see here, you can see the screen, new registration. In the new registration, there are two parts. First part is new registration part. Second part is temporary reference number. You need this number. So first one, you don't spend money, don't waste money. Registration is very, very, very simple. I'm going to completely cover you the registration today.
So it's within 3 days, I got chef at home either.
You're a great boss, but we want to let us make everybody great. So registration is simple. Don't waste money. Directly go to the gst.gov.in site. Just what there is a first question is asked is I am. What does that mean? You can't say I am a mutual fund advisor or what it is. It is, you should say I am a taxpayer or I am a GST practitioner. If you are going through a practitioner, that GST practitioner will put I am a GST practitioner. It is for you, you have to select I am a taxpayer. Then you select your state, whatever state you are, then district, then your legal name, permanent name. Legal name of business, as mentioned in the PAN, very, very important. I know a lot of our friends are having a company. See, one of my friends is having a company called MoneyCare. His legal name is, in PAN, his name is Srinivasan. Okay? Srinivasan is a PAN name because he's a proprietor. But name of his company is MoneyCare. So in that case, he has to put his name here. Legal name of business means don't put your business name, put your PAN. As mentioned in PAN.
Right.
Okay, that name you put it. Then your permanent account number, then your email address, then after email address, your mobile number. These two things are important because GST department is going to contact you only based on that numbers. Then you put proceed. Once you give proceed, you will be getting an OTP in the mobile number which you have mentioned. And use that. It may be a mobile YouTube OTP may come in your mobile, or they may send it in email ID also. Both they are doing both the ways. This way, that way, something it is happening. And once you, sometimes people will say that, sir, I have done it, sir, but I have not got the number at all. Please do check your spam folder also, because GST is always here. I didn't say that. So put it in, check your spam folder also. Then once it is done, you go to the next proceed. Once you submit the button proceed, what you will get is you will be getting a TRN number, which is very, very, very important. You take that TRN number and go back to the site again, gst.gov.in. In that, now you have done with this. Now you are going to the next step called temporary reference number. Now you already have, because they, once you have got registered, you are given the information, they will send you a TRN number. With that TRN number, you put over that TRN number and whatever the email which you can't read, you put it here. Then put proceed. If you can't read it, nothing, no problem, just press on this, they will. Or you can refresh it and you can make different images, you will get it. Then once you proceed, you will enter the world of GST. Happy? Happy to pay? 18%. Few more days. I think it should go because already there are a lot of this thing is going on. We have met our team and our friends have met a lot of people from finance ministry and all finance secretaries and different teams have been met. A lot of discussion is going on because GST is to be borne by whom?
Consumer.
Are you the consumer?
No.
Wait, that things is happening. So few days we have to bear the pain. Be happy like what we have said. Once you are happy, and you need not worry also, sir, I have taken registration, what to do now? Should I file the return regularly? Don't worry at all. You can surrender your registration any
time.
Very good. So here, everything is here. Then once you get this screen, you will get a screen like this. Here you are going to put all the information. It's going to ask you certain information like your business detail. You can take a photograph of this, because before you go and get yourself registered, this is a must. That is the JPEG or PDF mode. Example, if it is the business details, you have to put your ARN card or ARN certificate. Some people will have ARN certificate. That is, you take, in my case, my company, I have a partnership company, I'll have only certificate. I'll not have card. Only I'll have EUIN card. For you, if you are an individual or a proprietor, you will have a card. That card copy, you have to scan it and keep it. If you are a partnership firm, that partnership deed copy.
Private limited,
the procedure to zyada hai.
In case of individual?
Individual to only your ARN card, sir. Individual card, ARN card, ARN card. For registration certificate, business detail, ARN card is required, which should not be more than 1 MB, which is very, very important. Otherwise, you will be wasting time on the registration. Everything you will fill, last question you go and submit, it will say time out. Because it is within 15 minutes you have to finish that, otherwise time will get bad and it will go off. So 1 MB and promoters or partners photograph each, it should not be more than 100 KB. You can ask me how to make it 100 KB. I have a photo of 500 KB or 1 MB. Simple, go to Paint, reduce the resolution of the photograph. Once you reduce the resolution of the photograph, the KBs will come down. Like your calories coming down. You have to burn the calories. You can add on. You need to add on all those things. I'll come to that, because half an hour, one day ka program, half day, half an hour. Then authorized signatory. If you have, you see, partners concerned, I have four partners. One is the authorized signatory, two partners authorized signatory. You can make like that. Up to 10 authorized signatories, you can do it. If you have 40, 20 partners, 30 partners, 10 partners, like that, and all possible.
Or individual,
you are only person. So all these bank details, all the statements, you have to keep it ready. Once these details are ready, you are going to, as I told you earlier, what is your trade name? And what is your legal name? Legal name is your PAN name, don't get confused. Legal name is your PAN name, and trade name is
business name.
And don't ever, there will be some more forms like this, casual tax person, and all these things, say no, and go away. Okay? And then points to remember, for digital signature also, you need not go for digital signature. Don't waste money of 750 rupees for 2 years. Your Aadhaar card itself enough for validating your account.
Trade name, individual.
I am an individual. I told you, I run a company called MoneyCare.
Okay.
And I am the proprietor of MoneyCare. And my, as per PAN card, I will not have a MoneyCare as a card. My name will be Srinivasan there. So it is considered as your legal name is your PAN name.
Okay.
Your trade name is the way you are making your trade. That is, I'm calling my business as MoneyCare.
No.
If your AMFI card says that Srinivasan and both Srinivasan, you don't have a proprietary company, both is Srinivasan only. There are people who have MoneyCare, my friend, I told you, his company name is MoneyCare, and his legal name, as per income tax, his name is?
Company name is ARN card.
Oh, correct. Whatever there in your ARN card, that is as a company name, trade name, and whatever in your PAN card, legally. Simple. You take it that way. 15 minutes baki hai, so dekhta hai. Mere ko.
Previous
Yes. We'll come for the questions. Let me finish it so that the questions will take it so that we'll have more time. Let me finish faster. Okay? There'll be digital signature. Don't worry for digital signature at all. Use only your Aadhaar card. Try to get it faster. You get it faster. Throw away 100 rupees within 1 hour Aadhaar card ID. These are all things happening. Nothing is impossible in the world. You should make impossible. You should read always impossible as I am possible. Okay? And 1 minute. You send it. Sir, I will do one thing. I will send you this presentation full by WhatsApp to you. You send one SMS email, just a test WhatsApp to me. My number is 9840. Don't waste your battery, because full day you have already your struggle and your battery is getting drained down. 9840.
Sir, Telegram is the universe group.
Universe group hai. MFD universe. 9840858585. Bhool nahi sakta.
Another one also, we will have a copy and we will send to each and every.
Don't worry, today itself I will send it by WhatsApp right now. You just send, I will send it by WhatsApp.
Your name is?
My name is Ramesh Bhatt. Bhatt, BHAT. Agya? Okay, now see proof of appointment and other things. We'll go to the next one. Points to be noted, your SAC code is 997159. There's one more. What is that code? 44, it will start with 44, Business Auxiliary Services. You can use this service. Sab besam sab. Mobile niche, wo bola na. And see, next question is, who should sign the form? If you are a proprietor, all individuals are proprietor. There is no individual in the form at all. If you see in the GST registration form, there is no question of individual there. They'll all say you are a proprietor. Proprietor means the proprietor will sign. If it is a partnership company, managing partner will sign. If it is a company, LLP, everything, the authorized signatory will sign. Somebody asked me about the company part here. It is, then blah, blah, blah. Other things is you need not worry about that. This is the form. How to fill up the form now? First thing it will come is business detail. Your first thing comes here is that these are all the different 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tabs are there. Simple tabs. First tab is business detail. It is asking you go and if you go there, it is asking you the first question. It is asking you your legal name. They have mentioned here, so you need not get confused at all. Legal name is as per PAN, legal name as per business. Legal name as per business is as per your errand card. Put it that way, simple. And then you put your PAN number. Technology is always technology. Put your PAN number, then go to the next part. In the down itself, it is asking you your type. Then your registration number. Then your date of registration, all these things will come here. You have to add your document which you need to upload. I told you, take your errand card. Here you can upload your errand card. It should not be more than 1 MB. Then you upload it. Then save and continue. If you put save and continue, it will take you to the next tab. Automatically you will be taken to the next tab. And in the next tab, promoters but partners. If you don't have a partner, you are a only individual person, put all the details it is asking for. Please remember, as per your PAN card, your first name, all these names should match. Last name, middle name, first name. If it is the difference is there, in that case, what will happen is, you will get rejection again and again and again and again from GST. Those people will be sending you daily one love letter emails. Correct it. So, do as per what they say, your father name also like that, your date of birth, mobile number, email address, all this, male or female, all this, fill it up, and then again come to your Aadhaar number, fill your Aadhaar number, in case you have a passport, you put your passport number also, then, are you citizen of India? That question also, fill it up, Once you fill it up, all other questions will come. Then the promoters, in case of partnership only, this one. Otherwise, you need not worry. For there are some people who have partnership companies here also. Any partners, partnership company here? Then we'll skip up.
Private limited company.
Private limited company, again authorized signatory formal.
And digital signature.
Authorized signatory, private limited company. This is a very important part where you need a digital signature also. And whoever the authorized person who's going to sign his photograph and all the partners or all the directors authorizing that person, 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 or up to 10%, you can authorize. So any one among the 10 can sign. Then we have finished the first three part. Next, principal place of business. If you have only one place of business, then you can finish, put one place and go to the next one. If not, you have to put additional place of business if you have branches within the state or outside the state. Here, what is this? Here, principal place of business, what is the proof? They will ask for a proof for you. What is the principal of place? Another 10 minutes is there, right? Electricity bill. Somebody will say, the house is not in my name. Because I have attended various seminars I have taken on GST. There are a lot of problems. They will say, the property is in my father's name. What should I do? Property is in your father's name means you just get certificate. That is no objection certificate from your father. This property is in my name. I do not have my son, blah, 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 doing a mutual fund business in my place. That's all. That's enough. Complete. Telephone bill, okay.
BSN
landline. Daughter-in-law also, no problem. My father-in-law having a business here, no problem. One, no objection certificate. Parents, brother, sister, mother, whoever it is, they give a no objection. Maybe sister also, they give a no objection certificate. Just upload that no objection certificate and you can proceed. Simple. If the property is in your name, you need to put your proof. That is a corporation tax paid receipt is okay, or khata copy or whatever it is. Sorry? The place where you are doing business. This is for the place where you are doing the business. If you are doing the business here in this hotel, one room, then from the rent, whatever you pay to the hotel, agreement copy is to be enclosed. Got it?
If it is submitted as residential
proof,
address is given residence.
Then no problem. Residence address, if it is your own house. If it is a rented house, rental agreement copy.
Electricity bill, okay.
Okay. Electricity bill, okay.
Joint property.
Then if you are one of the owner, no problem. Khata copy, your name is there, highlight that.
Joint owner,
NOC manager, you are also owner of the property, no? That is itself, you highlight and send it, they accept it.
Sir, let's the topic over. Questions will be there, so without interruption, let's the motion will be there.
Then, what is the principal place of business? That's what we have finished it. And additional place of business, if you have any branches, you need to fill up this. Once that is through, goods and services tax, you say that HSN number, what I've told, those numbers you have to put, and again, save and continue. All this is through. Now your bank details. You will be filling your bank details here, and first page of the bank passbook. You will be having a passbook or bank statement. That statement you have to upload and save and continue. So your bank detail is also updated. Then finally comes the verification tab, where you have to tick here, and here automatically down arrow, because you might have put who is the authorized signatory already, just click that and submit. Once you submit, then you are married.
Okay.
Married with
GST.
Digital signature, I told you, these are all the formality. You can use only your Aadhaar card. That's the best way. Everything is okay, then you will get success. That means you have succeeded in life, marriage. Now, Sir, I have got my Aadhaar number, this number, GSTN number, sir. I got registered, sir. Next, should I give it in all AMC?
No.
Yes. No, fantastic. Yes. Go to CAMS. Yes. Here is a website where you can note CAMS.online/COL_distributor.ASPX. Go to that site. Here, this is, just type that site here. Go to distributor section. Then here, there is a GSTN. Go to this part, click on that part. You will get a link like this. You will get a like this, where you need to put, since people are getting confused, ARN number means they will put only 2130 or whatever number, 1234. So, to not to confuse you, they have put again ARN hyphen. So, you put your number alone, 4-digit or 5-digit or whatever number. That number and put your PAN number and generate OTP. What will happen? Once you generate OTP, you will get an OTP in your mobile or sometimes email also. Again, here it is the same way. Huh? Mobile or email. That is either way. So once you get it, put it there and submit. Once you submit, see, I have got, in my case, I got an email only. I got an email, here a number 2130, blah, blah, blah. And your number is, code number is valid for 15 minutes. Within 15 minutes, you have to do it. It's valid for 15 minutes and 201134, not to disclose with anybody. I have disclosed in here. So, GSTN number is through. Put that number back here. In the GSTN, this thing, put that number and submit it. Once you submit, then it will take you to this part. This part is the important part where these two will be already embedded. Only you have to select your state and you put your GSTN number, date of issue, submit date, automatically it will come. Then you have to upload the GSTN image, which you have got it. You can download it from the site. In the GSTN site itself, you can download it and that you can upload and submit. That's all. Your marriage is confirmed. Registered and confirmed.
I have one question.
And see, I don't register another 4.5, 4.5 minutes is there. Okay? I don't register, sir. Last, you are supposed to register 31st July itself. So far, you people have not registered. Will I get a notice? Yes. They will send you form GST 3A. This is the form they will be sending you as a notice. You are supposed to get yourself registered. Why you have not registered? These kind of things may come in, but not now. Finance Minister has given this thing that they will not penalize or send notice to anybody till 30th of September. These are all the form which you are going to file. Which you are going to file is annual return. You have to file once in a year annual return. Annual year is December 31st. That means, what is the clue you are getting? From next year onwards, the financial year is going to be the calendar year. This year onwards they are telling GST itself, it is a clue that they are giving. This year, that is why when we went and met the finance minister, PA, what he told us, sir, till November, don't make any hullabaloos. You, whatever your problem, you write and give and go. You are telling only the claims you should get, you write and give it and go. We will see that in November budget. He told same thing, November budget. That means, November we are going to get budget, January is going to be the new financial year.
Correct.
That means, our pain is for?
Payments.
Think, great, double. Everything will double. Okay? So this way, you are going to file one annual return and one form GSTR3. That you are going to file it on 20th. You need to pay the service tax. In the service tax regime, when did you pay service tax?
5th.
But in GST, you need to pay before?
20th.
You have 15 days extra to keep your money in liquid fund or whatever fund you want to keep and earn that 3% the way you are going to earn. And, sir, what is the procedure, sir? This is the procedure because I will hold the 3 minutes for question answer. So, this is the procedure. These are all, you need not worry about these procedure. Only step for you is GSTR3, which you have to do, make the payment, is the step number 7, which you have to do it by 20th. last month, sir, you asked me another question also. Here it's the questions. Because questions I have already created and I have put here. Sir, my annual return, when should I submit? It is 31st December. You need to file it before subsequent month. And you need to file along with the audited annual accounts. Audited annual accounts, you need to file that form. And sir, last month, commission nahi aaya tha. July month, there is no commission. Everything like this, everybody got it in the June itself. No AMC has paid, two or three AMCs has paid. Should I file it? Yes, you file it. But if you don't have any commission at all last month, you need to file nil return. You cannot skip. Return, already return filing open. It is already open from today. The first time I've seen it in the already online, the return filing started from today. You can start filing for your 10th dated today. So it is already started. It is mandatory even though you don't get any commission for any month. And if you don't file the previous month return, then you cannot file the current month ka return. That's compulsory. Then 10th deadline. If you miss out that 10th deadline, you will be charged a minimum penalty of 500, and there is a penalty class where 100 per day or 5000, whichever is lower. Whichever is lower. Because you have made a mistake, you have not filed it for 50 days and 60 days it has gone, then 5000 will be penalty. Because 60 means 16 to 100, 6000, 500, 5000 only. Or if you don't file your annual return on time, in case you don't file your annual return on time, then 0.25% of your annual turnover, 0.25% of your annual turnover, or 100 rupees per day, whichever is lower again. And this is the other, these are all the penalty classes. So far in civil, these are all civil. In case you any issues comes, it's all civil issues. This is not, in these cases, there was not much big arrest warrant at all, nothing was there. Now they can arrest you, imprisonment up to 6 months. Here it is a cognizable, non-bailable offense. If you have done this, it is a non-bailable offense. You will not get even bail. Like it is a criminal offense they are making it. If you don't file, these types of offenses, these kind of penalties have not come earlier in service tax or the earlier taxes. Now first time we are feeling all this, that section 73 and 74 is very serious, friends. So please abide by the rules and regulation and enjoy your GST and increase your income more and more and partner with the government. 18% plus 30% of your income tax, 48% pay them and you be with 20% only. Be happy, whatever it you are. Finish 1 minute before and I can take questions.
Sir,
one question is
like
if you have a
better answer to the ARN, for foreign ship to rise.
That you can do one thing, if he is not going to continue, don't just register GST. Ask MP Balkishna Gidi sir is here, or either send a mail to meena@ampindia.com. You send one mail to her and try to merge that with your regular. Yes. You can merge it. And see that, check with her in writing that will I get the drive? Because after merging, they should not say no. So take it in an email writing. Don't call. Send a mail, meena@ampindia.com. That's it. Mail ID. I can send it. You just send a this thing, test WhatsApp to me. 9840858585.
We have a next session with Mr. Nilesh Shah here right now. So those who are interested can stay back. Okay, he's coming. So if any queries, more queries about GST, you can contact Mr. Ramesh Bhatt 1-to-1.
Only whatever you are receiving, that you are.
Hello.
You are here.
Please be seated. Hello, listen, sir.